Now we're in the room, and you're likely going to start off with this, with a tutorial open for you, which you might want to go through. It'll help take you through all the steps of getting yourself set up. But in our case, we're just going to close it by clicking the X here. Okay, so what do we have? Well, you can see the room's open. If there's other people, we'd see them. But the first thing you're going to want to do is get your audio and video set up and make sure it's working properly. So you're going to click this Collaborate panel off in the bottom right corner. And I'm going to be going to My Settings, the little sprocket here, the fourth button along the bottom. So click that. And what we have is set up your camera and microphone. That's what you want to do. Click that. It's going to make you pick your audio device. It might choose default, but you can always go through if you have different microphones, you can pick. In my case, I'm using a headset. And you can even see my audio levels are rising and falling, which is a good sign. It means it's working. He even very encouragingly says, "You sound great." And if it's working, good. If not, it'll take you to help. So in my case, it's working. And it could also let you choose which webcam you want to use. In my case, I'm just using the inbuilt one on my laptop. Yes, it's working. Great. Now they wouldn't actually be turned on yet. They're not turned on. It just means they're ready to start working. And if you did want to start using it, you'd click the microphone here. In my case, I'm only going to click it for a second because otherwise it's going to make the audio go wonky on this video, but click it for a second and you should see the audio levels rising and falling here. That shows you that it's working properly. If the audio levels are rising and falling in that little microphone symbol, you know you're transmitting audio. Someone can't hear you, it's something on their end. If you wanted to share video, it would let you preview first, choose share video, and it's going to show up in a small window here. Everyone else would see you larger if you're talking. I'm going to turn it off though. A few other things worth noting is that you may have your instructors run the class just like a normal one where you have to raise your hand. If you do so, they will see that. And right here, you can actually choose your status. If you need to go away, you can. When you're ready to come back, you say, "I'm back." And you might, depending on how your class is run, you can even do things like, "Hey, I'm confused. I want you to go faster, slower. I agree with what you're saying or disagree." So, quick ways to respond and interact with the class. I also want to look over here, the chat. This is just like most chat areas that you've probably used. You can type in there. Everyone will see, you can see it's associated with your name so they know who's typing what. If you want, you can use an emoticon. Maybe you're happy. That's about everything. You're going to see everyone else's chat messages coming up in there as well. The last thing I want to demonstrate is the participant panel. And this is the second from the left along the bottom here. You can see it looks like it has people on it. And I've actually added another user just to help demonstrate some things. One thing I want to show right off the bat is remember, when you turn on your microphone, audio level is rising and falling here, but it also shows up beside the person's name if they turn it on. So if I turn this on, you can see it actually shows up beside my name. Now I'm turning it off because it's going to muddle this video a bit, but if your instructor had their microphone on as well, you should see it beside their name and you should see the audio levels rising and falling. If you do, it means they're transmitting audio. If you can't hear them, it's something on your end. If the audio levels are not rising and falling, you actually know it's something wrong on their end, you can let them know. The only other thing worth mentioning is that if you want to, you can send a private chat. If you hover beside someone's name and you click the three dots beside their name, you should have the option to send a chat message as long as your instructor has made this available to you. So if you did want to send a private chat message to your instructor, this is just something they would see. And then if you want to get back to the everyone chat, you'd click the arrow at the top, go back out, and then you click in to everyone where you'd be able to talk with everyone again. But otherwise, if your instructor has any other features they want you to use, they're likely to demonstrate them, and good luck.